ये वजीर मुमलिकत बराए खारजा उमूर हिना रबानी खर इस्लामाबाद में प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रही हैं।
अबाउट द कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव रिफॉर्म्स दैट हैव बीन कैरीड आउट इन पाकिस्तान इन द एएमएल सीएफटी डोमेन एंड द सस्टेन्ड मोमेंटम ऑफ आवर एफर्ट्स एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ द एफर्ट्स आल्सो बिकॉज एज यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट एक्शन प्लान टुक अस मच लॉन्गर दिस एक्शन प्लान वी हैव एक्चुअली एंडेड बिफोर टाइमलाइन एंड दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच वाज वेरी वेल रिकॉग्नाइज्ड थ्रू आउट द प्लेनरी बाय ऑल द members Pakistan's positive and speedy progress was greatly appreciated and welcomed by FATF members now FATF has acknowledged completion of both action plans by Pakistan the progress made and recognized by our commitment to improve our AML CFT systems consequent to the fruitful discussions held in the plenary the FATF has decided by consensus that Pakistan has addressed all technical benchmarks and has completed all requirements of both action plans that of 2018 and that of 2021 as a result of this what we consider to be no less than a herculean feat and a remarkable achievement FATF has now authorized an on-site visit of its technical team to Pakistan to validate the process of implementation of reforms Now let me emphasize over here because there might be some confusion this is part of the procedure of taking Pakistan out of the grey list when you authorize a country's removal from the grey list the second step is or the first step is that you authorize an on-site technical evaluation which has been done in this plenary the successful completion of FATF action plans and its formal endorsement by FATF means that Pakistan is one step away from exiting the grey list Inshallah. The on-site visit is a procedural requirement. It marks the beginning of the end process that will eventually culminate in the exit of Pakistan from the FATF's grey list. Inshallah and hopefully forever. We are closely working with FATF to arrange the on-site visit at mutually convenient dates with a view to conclude the entire process before the October plenary 2022. During our interactions on the sidelines of the FATF plenary, we stressed Pakistan's high-level political commitment to strengthen our AML-CFT regime and bring it at par with global standards. We have been highlighting complete national consensus, and I cannot emphasize on this enough. And I can assure you that it is this government's commitment that we will take this forward with national consensus, and we will celebrate the national consensus, inshallah. I want to take this opportunity to also stress once again that cooperation with FATF and the international community is grounded in our strategic objective, in our own strategic objective of strengthening our economy and improving its integration with the international financial system. I am confident that with this good news from FATF, it will restore confidence in our economy and will give us a much needed boost, improve investment climate and a robust AML-CFT compliance systems. I also want to acknowledge in fact I really want to emphasize on the tireless efforts of our teams who have really done a tremendous job and burnt the midnight oil in achieving all of these strenuous difficult complicated targets this was indeed a whole of country response and I think that is something to celebrate multiple departments agencies both at the federal and provincial levels have contributed to this national cause It also demonstrates that when we work together, all of country, all of nation, we can achieve sometimes what is considered to be impossible. I also want to say that this is going to be a cross-government effort. I really want to emphasize that because I know a lot of talk has been done about it. This is an effort for the state of Pakistan. Governments will come and go, but Pakistan's consensus and Pakistan's efforts on this, I hope, will continue in stride. I want to convey our gratitude to our international partners and friends for their understanding, for their constant support and cooperation throughout this lengthy, arduous process. By the grace of Allah, Pakistan is in a position now that it can not only sustain its trajectory of reforms well into the future, but also really, and that's what we look forward to, provide guidance and technical support to other countries in this area. We feel we are a little bit ahead of the curve. In fact, we are quite ahead of the curve. We want to sustain that. We want to sustain that place, continue to be ahead of the curve, to remain there, and really be in some ways a model for other countries to follow. I know that we are far ahead, within the financial regulatory systems, within CFT legislation, within AML legislation, within the PAC, within the region, but we're also looking very good when you compare us against international benchmarks. And I'm sure that we will be fully prepared for on-site visit, and we will exit the grey list at the earliest, inshallah. With that, I come to the end of my statement, but I want to emphasize over here one thing that we as a nation must remember and respect. That is some issues related to the confidentiality requirements within this. In the past, I want to emphasize this at the very outset, in the past, our urge to share news has harmed us. Okay, so I hope you noticed that we were very, very careful in allowing the plenary to take the decision, to announce the decision, because you can never prejudge. And any time you try to prejudge and speak before your time, it has always come back to hurt you. So this, as a nation, not only as a government, is something that we need to do well in order to complete the start of the end. And this will not be the end, because this will be, inshallah, then a new beginning, where Pakistan is looking towards strengthening its own systems according to its own requirements and get out of the requirements of having to report to others, but continue to report to itself.
Thank you, Madam Minister. I'm here to facilitate the questions and answers session. I already see a lot of interest. My only request would be, when you pose a question, please identify yourself and please restrict yourself to one question per person so that everyone has a chance. Yes, sir, please.
Sohail Bhatt from the Asian Telegraph. Sir, Pakistan was given a 27-point agenda in 2018 and another in 2021. Has FATF recognized that was unprecedented and a huge burden on a single country to implement two action plan?
Yes, it was quite unprecedented. We were, in fact, the only country which has had two simultaneous action plans to implement. And that's why I said it was tedious, it was arduous, it was difficult, it was technically requirements were cross-agency, cross-institutions. There was legal frameworks to take care of, there were amendments to do, and then there was institutionalization of those amendments of the new laws. Building of structures, building of systems. So really, I think it's too early to celebrate, because I genuinely believe that once, you know, you can't prejudge anything. We have an on-site visit, but we have started the process, as I said. And within that context, yes, we were the only country ever in the history of FATF to go through two simultaneous plans, action plans at the same time, one of 2021 and one of 2018, as you well know, which was a total of 34, working points altogether.
Mr. Jaz, second row.
मैं पाकिस्तान की जब भी एफएटीएफ के इजलास में गया तो पाकिस्तान होपफुल होता था कि इस मरतबा हम निकल जाएंगे, लेकिन ये बहुत लॉन्ग जर्नी तय करना पड़ा. वो कौन से की इश्यूज थे या की प्रॉब्लम्स थे जिनकी वजह से ये इतना टाइम लगा, और क्या जैसा हम सुनते हैं यहाँ इस्लामाबाद में बैठ करके फलां मुल्क का इन्फ्लुएंस है, फलां का इन्फ्लुएंस है, क्या कोई पॉलिटिकल इन्फ्लुएंस इस किस्म का था जो हर्डल रहा, या हम कहीं कुछ चीजों में लैग करते थे?
देखिए, आई थिंक एट दिस पॉइंट इन टाइम वी कैन बी पॉजिटिव अबाउट अर्जन. We have the luxury to be positive about Ajani, because give and take, eventually whatever we did was in Pakistan's interest. It strengthened Pakistan's systems to enable Pakistan to be able to be seen and to be also a responsible country, which is, in some ways providing a model of legal framework now to the world. We have always emphasized that FATF must remain apolitical and technical and impartial, obviously. This is an emphasis that we have always done at every interaction that we've had, and we would hope that will continue. Vis-a-vis, why did it not happen before? This was very intensive process. The action plan was minutely detailed. It required many, many actions, as I've just explained, at many, many different levels. So it was obviously time-consuming. जहाँ तक आपका सवाल था कि जी हम हमेशा होपफुल रहते होते थे, मेरे नजर में आपको प्रिपेयर, यू शुड बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द वर्स्ट एंड होप फॉर द बेस्ट. एंड आई hope you saw some of that being reflected, how this government took this up, because you need to be, and this preparation was over the last many years, so we absolutely are willing to share credit with whoever wants, you know, a piece of the pie. Hum tangmugay dene ke liye bhi taiyar hain jinko credit chahiye. I think this is a battle for Pakistan. This is not a battle for anyone at all.
Second row, Imran sir.
मोहम्मद इमरान दुनिया टीवी से। मैम अभी आपने कहा कि जो आप एक डिबेट चल रही है क्रेडिट की इस हवाले से, अभी आपने कहा कि जो क्रेडिट लेना चाहते हैं हम देने के भी तैयार हैं, तंबुए भी देने के लिए तैयार हैं। तो जब ये सारी लेजिस्लेशन हो रही थी, जब प्रोसेस हो रहा था, तो उस लेजिस्लेशन के दौरान तो पीडीएम जिसका आप पार्ट एंड पार्सल थी, तो वो बायकॉट करता रहा, वॉकआउट करते रहे। तो फिर अब जाकर इसको रियासत का फैसला और रियासत की विक्ट्री डिक्लेयर कर रही है, तो उस वक्त अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं थी कि ये रियासत के लिए बहुत जरूरी है इस लेजिस्लेशन को पास करना?
नहीं, देखिए वो ही लेजिस्लेशन हमने कमिटीज में, पार्लियामेंट्री कमिटीज में पास की, ऑपोजिशन ने मिलकर पास की। हमें तरीका कार से प्रॉब्लम थी, बिकॉज बुलडोज करना और जो आप बात करें कि कंसेंसस बिल्ड करना, उसके साथ में एंगेज करना, वो सब कुछ नहीं हुआ। बट लेट बायगॉन्स बी बायगॉन्स। आई थिंक पाकिस्तान शुड बी फॉरवर्ड लुकिंग, पाकिस्तान शुड बी फोकस्ड, पाकिस्तान शुड हैव ऑल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट अप्रोच, पाकिस्तान शुड हैव ऑल ऑफ नेशन अप्रोच, एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई एम सेइंग लेट्स नॉट बॉग अर्सेल्व्स डाउन विद दीज अननेसेसरी डिबेट्स। देयर अननेसेसरी, देयर इफ एनीथिंग दे डोंट ब्रिंग एनी गुड। सो मैं ये कह रही हूं कि मैं सिर्फ क्रेडिट अगर दूंगी तो अपनी टीम को दूंगी, और टीम अपनी, जब मैं कहती हूं, मैं पाकिस्तान की टीम कहती हूं, क्योंकि अभी हम गवर्नमेंट रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं, वी आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द स्टेट ऑफ पाकिस्तान राइट नाउ। सो आई वुड गिव क्रेडिट टू एवरी मेंबर ऑफ द टीम, दोज हु आर सेलिब्रेटेड, हु आर विजिबल इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, एंड दोज हु आर नॉट, हु आर इन द बैकग्राउंड, एंड परहैप्स द वंस इन द बैकग्राउंड डू मच मोर वर्क देन द वंस दैट आर विजिबल। सो आई वुड रियली, आई नो हाउ मच वर्क हैज गॉन इनटू इट बाय वेरियस एजेंसीज, बाय वेरियस एंटिटीज। So I think we need to, and having said that, I still need to say, let's not be overly celebratory right now. Na, matlab we still have the process has started, but abhi the on-site visit is due, and ye karne ke baad bhi hamari journey to continue karegi. This strengthening of legislation, strengthening of administration will continue.
Adil sir, followed by Anas.
This is Adil Bashir from Rose News. The first question is, do you think that there was a political motivation for keeping Pakistan on the grey list for such a long time? The other one is, was there an issue in our foreign policy due to which Pakistan was placed on the grey list? Were we not able to present our case before FATF in an effective manner? Thank you.
Again, I will desist from commenting on anything which casts a negative light on any effort that has been done at all. So I will skip your last two questions and come to your first question. Was Pakistan's grey listing in any way political? As I said, we have always emphasized that FATF must remain apolitical in its conduct, because it's an important body, it has an important work to do. However, we do know that there were certain countries involved, a certain singular country at least that we all can name and emphasize, which has always tried to make this process a political one, and which has been a spanner in the wheels. And to realize that that certain countries, in the presence of that certain country, we got this through consensus is an important point. So we had to be more white than others, for sure, but that means we matlab that just shows you how much meaning, how much we have attained, how much we have achieved.
Anas.
Thank you so much, spokesperson Anas Moliman. My question is for you, that upon the conclusion of the February 2019 plenary, we saw a statement coming in from the FATF that specified that Pakistan needs to take action, particularly on counter-terror financing, against 34 individuals of 8 organizations of concern. And those organizations were named, namely Al-Qaeda, Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jamaat-ul-Dawa, Jaish-e-Mohammed, the Tehreek-e-Taliban Afghanistan, the Haqqani Network. Now my question is very specific. What has Pakistan done against these 34 individuals as specified by the FATF to convince them, number one? And number two, yesterday we saw in the press conference by the FATF president that it called for an irreversible action. So what is Pakistan going to do ahead of the visit, the on-site visit, to convince them that yes, this action is irreversible? Thank you.
देखिए, लेट्स गेट द फैक्ट्स करेक्ट. ओके, पाकिस्तान डजंट नीड टू डू एनीथिंग फ्रॉम नाउ अंटिल ऑन साइट विजिट. व्हाट पाकिस्तान नीड्स टू डू इज टू प्रिपेयर इटसेल्फ फॉर एन ऑन साइट विजिट व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी टेक्निकल इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ऑल द क्लेम्स दैट पाकिस्तान हैज मेड व्हिच हैव बीन एक्सेप्टेड. एज आई सेड, ऑल एक्शन प्लान आइटम्स हैव बीन टिक्ड ऑफ, लार्जली एड्रेस्ड. नथिंग इज पेंडिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑन पाकिस्तान टू डू. नो एक्शंस आर पेंडिंग ऑन पाकिस्तान टू डू. Now, when it comes to the specifics of, you know, clearly we did enough to get a green light on this, right? That we ticked all the boxes. And within that context, I just want to say that let's be clear. I think when it comes to the prosecution, going after people, anyone who's involved in terrorism financing, that's an agenda that Pakistan has also. It's a national agenda also. So when does a country do well? A country is able to do well within the international framework when its domestic agenda and international agenda is aligned. I feel it is aligned. So we're not doing anything for anyone. We're doing it for Pakistan, and in the process, we're ensuring that our economy also gets the boost, because no country, and this question was asked to me in Berlin also, no country would ever like to be on the grey list. It has repercussions, it has ramifications, and no country would choose to remain on the grey list.
Take one question from there, Kamran, followed by Ms. Roma. Saad.
My name is Kamran Raja, and I have two questions. Recently, Pakistan got a good news from FATF, and which leads Pakistan to exit from the FATF grey list. And second, my question is, do you see the role of any specific political party or institution in completing our FATF action plans? And my second question is that, what actions have been taken to enable our institutions to meet the future challenges in the anti-money laundering and CFT, combating financial terrorism?
I didn't quite understand your last question, second question. What actions are going to be taken? Ji, as I said.
For anti-money laundering and for combating financial terrorism.
Okay. Dekhe, I think it's less about specific actions and more about the framework that you build, right? As I said, there were lots of issues that, you know, there was a lot of work that went into it. If you look at the list of amendments and new legislation that we had to do, it's actually like
30 plus
altogether, some at the provincial level, some at the national level, some at various levels. Now, you can't just do legislation. You also have to make sure that that legislation is implementable. For that, you have to work on the institutions that are going to implement it, create different frameworks, create different bodies. So this has been a very intensive process. I think what we have now is a good body of work, of legislation, and institutional strengthening that exists for us to have a speed of our own. And as I mentioned to you earlier, what we would want is, what is an ideal scenario for Pakistan? That Pakistan gets out of the vagaries of reporting to an international agency and gets into reporting to its own system and working within its own legal framework to achieve what we consider to be national priorities also. As I said, they're aligned over here. They're not counter to our national priorities in any way. Aur aapka pehla question tha, any institution, dekhen, I said it at the very outset, I think in the last 20 years of having been in this space, there's one thing that I've learned, there's no limit to what you can achieve if you don't care who gets the credit. As on behalf of the Foreign Office of Pakistan, the nation, many institutions, pretty much when we say national consensus, we're referring to the parliament, we're referring to everyone. We are saying this is a Pakistan win. Let it remain a Pakistan win. Yeah.
Zishan, over there.
Zishan Bhatti from PTV News. India has been leaking reports of FATF in violation of FATF rules. Has Pakistan raised this issue with FATF? And secondly, what lessons have been learned by Pakistan during the last 4 years in this process?
Okay, the second question can take a whole day. I think we've learned many lessons, and the one, perhaps the biggest lesson that we've learned is that it is wise to ensure, for instance, in the fact of, you know, in interacting with people, I said the message from Pakistan is never again. That's a lesson learned. Never again will we want to be part of any list which requires us to divert our attention from our national requirements to just reporting requirements. So never again is the lesson that we've learned, that we never want to slip into this again. That's the biggest lesson. On confidentiality rules, what do you think is the answer? Of course we did. And within that context, I have to say I feel covered some ground, because I think it is a very... Why are we so respectful of this? Why are we so respectful of the fact that we don't share information which is not meant to be shared? Because there are very strong confidentiality rules. FATF takes it very, very seriously. So you're actually endangering the credibility of the country when you do that. Now, that certain country that you mentioned has openly been doing it, okay, and has been openly caught doing it. And there is obviously a great deal of, I think, understanding amongst other members that that is incorrect and should not happen. But we, even within that context, I say, let's concentrate on the positive, let's concentrate on what we've been able to do, and that is an area that we are taking care of, that we are taking up with everyone, that we are raising at every forum.
First row, Shabir.
So, as we know that, I'm Shabir Wagra from PTV World, as we know that different ministries play a role in this whole process. So, what role Ministry of Foreign Affairs has played during Pakistan's grey listing, and also now how these responsibilities has changed with the delegation of all the responsibilities on you as Minister of State being in charge?
Well, how that responsibility? I think Ministry of Foreign Affairs has actually been playing a role even when its minister or Minister of State was not leading the National Steering Committee. I think most of you might be very well aware of it. We were playing the critical role throughout this process in the last 4 years. The ministry was actually housing all the major or the lead agency in all the major interactions. Sometimes, like many of us, going beyond the call of duty. I know our DGCT and different people have taken that role, and the one who is currently there, all the officers within that team. I'm actually very, very impressed when I get any briefings from them, when I see them work, and knowing how much hard work they've put in and how ahead of the curve they are. So to me, obviously, this ministry has played a pivotal role in the strategic planning, in their interagency work, inter-provincial coordination sometimes. Sometimes having to go down to, I don't want to again go into the details, but allow me to say that, yes, we have played a critical role. We will continue to play in a critical or a crucial role. And as I said, I think it's very important, it's exceptionally important that we recognize everyone's effort in this. This could not have been done by any single entity, ministry, institution, foreign affairs, anyone. Had you said, we will take care of anything, virtually impossible to do it. So yes, we've been playing a critical role, and inshallah, we will continue to play an effective
role. Question from the gentleman in the first row, followed by Mr. Piracha in the last row.
We're watching this legislation work in the context of FATF, and then there was an institutional format that was coming up. And I personally saw that there was some policy reluctance and capacity deficiency. Mm-hmm. What do you think about it?
Policy reluctance and capacity deficiency. Because policy reluctance and capacity deficiency are part of life, right? And you always keep on wanting to strengthen the deficiencies that exist. When I say that we are now not only comparable to international standards, but ahead of international standards. So if you look at overall FATF recommendations and where Pakistan stands and where some of the developed countries stand, you will be shocked. We are ahead of the curve in many ways. Now the challenge for us is to continue with this momentum, inshallah, even after we are out of this process. That is the challenge for Pakistan, and that is also the concern that has been raised. And for that, institutionalization of this whole process is exceptionally important. So I think from now onwards, we have to strengthen the institutions whose core responsibility, DG saab yahan baithe hain, jinki core responsibility is process ko aage leke jana hoga. And by the way, in answer to that question, obviously we can't miss out the foreign affairs, because I think we were doing so much which was not our core role, that I mentioned all of that, and not mention the intensive diplomatic work that we had to do at the level of the foreign minister also. Consistently, persistently, every interaction that we have, every capital. And this diplomatic work happens from top down, all of government approach. But so I think the role of the diplomatic outreach that we did is quite substantial. I would weigh on it very heavily, because you can have a very good case, but you also have to present the good case in a good way. I think we can. Okay.
Thank you, Madam, for MOS. Glad to find you back in the leadership role of this ministry. When we say, जब हम ये कहते हैं कि on-site inspection के लिए team आएगी, वो क्या देखने आएंगे? क्या जेलों में बंद लोगों को देखने आएंगे कि वाकई वो बंद हैं, या कोई ऐसा स्ट्रक्चर खड़ा है जिसको आपकी हुकूमत ने पेपर्स में या पाकिस्तान की रियासत ने पेपर्स में डिसमेंटल किया है, क्या वो देखने आएंगे? सेकेंडली, सिंस इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ काउंटर टेररिज्म, whether there was any concern about ongoing talks in Kabul or Peshawar with the TTP person, because the ultimate goal is to fight out terrorist entities, not to negotiate with them. Thank you.
Sure. Interesting questions. On the second question, I will just say before, as you know, FATF is supposed to be a completely technical body, right? Once you go into, through a process, once you're nominated to be graylisted, there is a process that you follow and there is an action plan given, and that action plan is quite specific to what needs to be done. So the second question, yours, does not arise, because this is obviously not part of any of the action plan items at all. This is an internal matter for Pakistan, I think, and this is obviously has no bearing on the work that we did with FATF. And you have asked what you will see. आई थिंक देखिए, मैंने पहले बहुत वजाहत में कहा, और मैं ये वजाहत भी कर रही हूँ और सच्चाई भी कह रही हूँ, कि वो ये देखने आएंगी कि जो जो चीजें हमने रिपोर्ट की हैं, कि ये हम लेजिस्लेशन कर चुके हैं, ये हम बॉडी बना चुके हैं, फैटिव सेक्रेटेरिएट है, ऑपरेट करता है, उसके नीचे और लोग ऑपरेट करते हैं, इंटर प्रोविंशियल कोऑर्डिनेशन कैसे होती है, नेशनल एंड प्रोविंशियल की कोऑर्डिनेशन के लिए कौन सी बॉडी है, नेशनल स्टीयरिंग कमेटी का क्या काम है, वर्किंग ग्रुप का क्या काम है, कौन सी एजेंसी क्या क्या करी है, ये सब कुछ एक टेक्निकल इवैल्यूएशन, ऑन साइट इवैल्यूएशन में देखी जाएगी. सो इसमें कोई पॉइंट्स भी नहीं है, वो भाम भी नहीं है, ढकी छुपी बात भी नहीं है. लेकिन अगर हम बहुत डिटेल में ये सब कुछ नहीं जाना चाहेंगे, वो इसलिए नहीं जाना चाहेंगे बिकॉज उनका एक टेक्निकल काम है. अगर उसके आगे पीछे बहुत क्यास राय हो जाए, मैं ये बार बार दो टोक अल्फाज में कह रही हूं, उसने पाकिस्तान को हार्म किया है. और अर्ज टू quickly, share the news or to be the winner in giving you the news has always harmed us. Okay, so इनके काम को हमने उनको स्पेस देनी है और उनको ये कम्फर्ट प्रोवाइड करना है कि आप अपना काम आराम से कर सकेंगे यहाँ पे. सो हमारी बहुत कोशिश होगी कि हम उनका काम आराम से, सुकून से, उनको एक टेक्निकल तरीके से हैंडल होता जाए और उसको किसी तरीके से पोलिटिसाइज ना किया जाए. और आप लोग ये सारे प्लीज समझें कि हमारे इंटरेस्ट में है कि ये टाइम पे हो जाए. इस वक्त अगर हमारे सामने कोई गोल है, कोई ऑब्जेक्टिव है जिसके ऊपर टाइमलाइन है, वो ये है कि हम अक्टूबर 2022 की प्लेनरी से पहले ये तमाम प्रोसेस खत्म कर लें. दैट्स नॉट गोइंग टू बी एन इजी टास्क, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू बी एन इम्पॉसिबल टास्क ऑल्सो, बट इट विल रिक्वायर सम हार्ड वर्क एंड सम क्वाइट, समटाइम्स डिप्लोमेसी, समटाइम्स क्वाइट हार्ड वर्क एट द टेक्निकल लेवल. सो वी आर वेरी कीन टू सी दिस प्रोसेस थ्रू क्वाइटली. आई एम एम्फसाइजिंग दैट वर्ड, क्वाइटली.
Mr. Naveed Siddiqui and the gentleman on your right, both of you, one after the other.
Thank you. This is Naveed Siddiqui from Dawn News. Ma'am, there are reports that some friendly countries of Pakistan have helped to get Pakistan out of grey list. Your comments, please.
Okay, I will say this with a lot of confidence, that friendly countries, I mentioned to you diplomatic outreach, that's always there. Diplomatic outreach to say, but diplomatic outreach, please pay attention, I want to emphasize this. Diplomatic outreach for one possibility could be, oh, Pakistan is not able to do its work, Pakistan has not done anything on its action plan, but please help us. Versus diplomatic outreach, we have not only honored all of our commitments, we have overperformed, we have not only met the timelines, we have outperformed the timelines, we have done it ahead of time. So now the friendly country's assistance in some ways is an assistance that we deserve. So
any example?
Nay, I'm not going to name them just simply because I think they can. We know who are the friendly countries. All I'm saying is Pakistan has deserved this. Please, I want you to, completely. Yes, we always reach out to many friendly countries, but I want to emphasize this, that Pakistan has earned this process. The start of the end is something that Pakistan has earned through its sheer hard work, through consistent, persistent work, and through an across the different strains of government, national approach to problem solving. So we have really earned this place. And diplomatic outreach is obviously very important because jo aap baat kar rahe the pehle ki ji political ho jata hai kabhi kabhi, humne usko political nahi hone diya, aap ye samajh lein. Humne kisi ek mulk ko is pure process ko political nahi hone diya aur uske liye humne bahut sare friendly countries ke sath engagement, bahut intensive engagement rakhi at every level. I mentioned even at the foreign minister's level, at every level.
My name is Abdul Sattar. I'm from NPR, National Public Radio of America. I'm here.
Okay.
Pakistan has really worked hard to ensure that it comes out of that list. But do you think turning a blind eye allegedly or permitting groups like Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan, Defense-e-Sahaba and some other extremist groups to roam about the country carrying out hate mongering against religious and sectarian minorities and trying to harm Pakistan's relation with important countries that are the part of the European Union that also play an important role in FATF could pose any challenge, or you think it is purely internal issue of Pakistan?
No, dekhe, nothing remains an internal issue when it has problematic repercussions, right? But as I said at the very outset, and I think I would like to limit myself to that, that what is the lesson learnt, it was asked. The lesson learnt is never again. Not for the sake of others, but for the sake of ourselves. Pakistan wants to have a very different reputation than the one that we've bogged ourselves down for many, many decades. We need to move away from that. And we have happily started that trajectory. I think the start of the trajectory, frankly speaking, was in 2008 after, you know, we decided ke, yes, you can talk, but if talks fail, then you have to do something about it, right? So I'm quite confident, inshallah, that if we do not bicker, do not let this momentum go away, we should very clearly be on the trajectory of our way out. And again, as I said, never again. Never go back to the same place. Never make the same mistakes again.
Last row, Changiz sir.
Changiz Khan Jadoon Unji, Pyame Khyber News se. 22 करोड़ आवाम जो थी वो आपकी मुंतजर थी मैडम मिनिस्टर के. कल जिस वक्त आपकी वीडियो वायरल हुई तो दफ्तर खारजा ने उसे फौरी तौर पे आगे चलाया, जिसकी वजह से सांसें जो थी वो बहाल हुई 22 करोड़ आवाम की जब आपने ये खुशखबरी सुनाई. अब आपसे सवाल ये है कि जैसा कि अभी आपने अपनी स्टेटमेंट में भी फरमाया कि लेजिस्लेशन या जितने मामलात हैं वो सारे हमारे स्मूथली हो रहे हैं, चाहे मईशत है चाहे इंसानी हकूक है. हमारे पड़ोस में एक ऐसा मुल्क है जिसने इंडिया कश्मीर पे कब्जा किया हुआ है, कभी वो BLA की सूरत में हम पे हमला आवर होता है, कभी TTP की सूरत में, कभी कुलभूषण जाधव की सूरत. क्या FATF को वहां कुछ भी नहीं नजर आता? कभी हिंदुस्तान के अंदर जो है वो जो मुसलमानों का कत्लेआम हो रहा है, उनकी अमलाक जलाई जा रही है, वहां उनको कुछ नजर नहीं आता?
वजीर मुमलिकत बराए खारजा उमूर हिना रब्बानी घर इस्लामाबाद में प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रही थी, जो आपने बराह रास्त मुलाहिजा की.